The problem with a keto breakfast is that they can get boring if you do not think outside of the box. So the aim of this video is to look at variety around a couple of food groups. We're not going to take up a lot of your time in me showing you how to prepare them in the kitchen, as we know that you'll be able to put these together easily yourself. So that we do not take up a lot of your time with you having to write notes, you may cut and paste all of the ideas from the description below. They work equally well for lunch and dinners too. For example, we know how to cook eggs for breakfast, fried, poached, boiled, scrambled, but I found the omelets are the easiest way to add variety into your breakfast. You can play around with these ingredients that we list to suit. Similarly, you can bake a large portion, and you can spread this out over a few days if you're looking for meals in advance. The first 20 ideas are keto omelets. The first 8 contain cheese, and the timeline along the red bar at the bottom will help you skip ahead if you're not into eating cheese. The first one we start with is a basic cheese omelet, and the way you can vary that is you can add goat, sheep, cow's cheese, or buffalo mozzarella. Next, we have spinach and goat's cheese, smoked salmon and cream cheese, asparagus and cream cheese and chives, broccoli and cheese, ham and feta cheese, cream cheese and chives, chorizo and cheese. Next, we're going to look at some omelets without cheese. Chorizo on its own, just as a chorizo omelet. Mushroom, finely chopped herbs, mushroom, peppers, and onion. Aubergine, often called eggplant and onion. Diced chicken and broccoli. Zucchini, chili, and crispy bacon. Avocado, mushroom, onion, chopped peppers. Chopped ham, onion. Chopped green peppers, chopped spring onion, mushroom, spinach, and zucchini, bacon and mushroom, turkey, peppers, and tomato. Next, we're going to look at what I will call a keto sausage. Because bacon and sausage can become boring after a while for breakfast, we're going to look at a few variations on that theme. Chicken, turkey, and lamb and beef are not normally considered breakfast choices. But if you buy them already minced and mix them with the following: spinach, cheese, broccoli, onion, mushroom, or tomato, either mixed together or individually, can form what I term as the keto sausage. You start by frying the meat until it's fully cooked and then add one or more of the ingredients, that's the spinach, cheese, broccoli, onion, mushroom, or tomatoes, into the pan just at the time when the meat is fully cooked. And leave them cooking for a while to bring them up to the same temperature. Then you divide the mixture into sausage-sized portions. At that point, I use black pepper, salt, spices to liven them up, give them some flavor. Similarly, I use chorizo as another ingredient that can spice up the open sausage. If you batch them, if you bake or batch them into larger portions, you can also freeze them. Cheese is another ingredient if you don't have a milk allergy that can be versatile when it comes to spicing up breakfast. For example, spinach or zucchini and cream cheese alone, with or without the open sausage. Similarly, if you warm chop tomatoes and add cheese or cream cheese, that can be an interesting choice. The way that I work these, first of all, is to put the spinach or the tomatoes in the pan, warm them, and then add the cheese until it melts. Fish is another food that's often overlooked for breakfast. Kippers or smoked mackerel are a couple of good examples that I use. Now, the aim of these breakfast choices is just to get you thinking outside of the box so you're able to purchase the ingredients in advance and experiment on your own. Hopefully, these ideas have helped, and please remember to subscribe and hit the update bell.